Hello and welcome. Thank you for spending your time with me today to enjoy art and nature. Hello and nice to be with you today. And today we're going to talk about buds. And buds are wonderful. And the first time we talked about seeds, then we talked about roots and sprouts, then we talked about leaves, and today we're going to do the bud right before the flower. Don't look at the flower. And I'm going to start today by reading you a poem. And this poem is by Galway Kinnell, titled St. Francis and the Sow. The bud stands for all things, even for those things that don't flower. For everything flowers from within, of self-blessing. Though sometimes it is necessary to reteach a thing its loveliness, to put a hand on the brow of the flower and retell it in words and in touch, it is lovely, until it flowers again from within of self-blessing. As St. Francis put his hand on the creased forehead of the sow and told her in words and in touch, blessings of the earth on the sow, and the sow began remembering all her thick length from the earthen snout all the way through the fodder and slops to the spiritual curl of the tail, from the hard spininess spiked out from the spine, down through the great broken heart, to the blue milk and dreamingness spurting and shuddering from 14 teats into the 14 mouths, sucking and blowing beneath them the long, perfect loveliness of sow. And so we're going to consider the loveliness of the bud. And the bud, you can see, comes right out of the plant. And inside these little buds, there are perfect little flowers. But today we're going to concentrate on the shape of the bud, and we're going to begin by drawing. So take out your pencils and your paper, and let's look at the shape of the bud in the air. And the buds that I'm looking at, they're going straight down, and then they swing around like that. So I'm going to do a nice long arch. It's a very similar shape to the seed and the leaf, isn't it? And there's our little bud. And I'll draw it for you in the marker so you can see it. And I'm going to leave the bud right here so we don't forget it. We are. And you know what? Let's ask Greg some questions about buds.
Thank you, Judy. That's a great drawing of a bud. So let's talk about buds. What are buds? Buds are little tiny structures on plants, and a bud can turn into a leaf or a flower. Here's one of my favorite plants. It's a borage, and it's got a lot of leaves and a lot of flowers on it. Its flowers are blue. They started out as a small bud and grew into these beautiful flowers. Here's a tiny leaf, and here's a tiny leaf bud. Another one of our favorite flowers is the mallow. It has a lot of buds on the very top, and as they age, they swell and start to show their true colors. And here, they've opened up into a full flower. After a while, the flower petals will fall off and a seed pod is left in its place. Here is one right here. This seed pod is full of seeds, and once they dry out and mature, they'll be ready to sprout, starting the whole process over. Here's another one of our favorite plants. This is the strawberry plant. As you can see, it's got beautiful buds. They're not as showy as the mallow, but the bees really like them, and bees need plants because they make honey. Here is the strawberry flower. Our next flower is real important also. You probably remember the zucchini plant we talked about 2 weeks ago. This is its flower. It's really important. Without it, we couldn't get zucchini. And here is a baby zucchini. Another important shoot, our bud, is the geranium. And you can see it's tiny little flowers just opening up here. This plant also has a nice scent. If you roll its leaves a little bit, you can smell a nice fruity scent. This variety is called Tutti Frutti.
Well, thank you, Greg. And aren't plants fascinating? Isn't this just an amazing world? All right, so back to painting. Now we're going to take our colors, red, blue, yellow, black, and white. And I'm working with benzimazidone yellow, a beautiful yellow, quinacridone magenta, phthalo blue, carbon black, and titanium white. And these are the fluid acrylics. These are golden fluid acrylics. And they create a wonderful smooth brushstroke. I'm going to give us a special color today, an iridescent copper. And remember the bud shape that we just drew. I'm going to start with red, and I'm going to sweep around and down, and I've got that wonderful pendulous shape. And when you look at buds, you'll see, are they smooth? Are they soft? Are they firm? And what's going to come out of that bud? That's the exciting thing about a bud, is what's coming out. Almost like a caterpillar's cocoon, the anticipation of what's coming next is so present. And I'll just remind you, when I paint and I want to mix a color, I do it right on the board. If I want to make pink, I take a little white, another way I can do it, and a little red. And look at how I made a pink color there. I just used a little bit of paint right on my palette. I didn't take all my red and all my white. I just took a little tiny bit. Are you enjoying painting a bud today? And what do you think is going to come out of that bud? Do you think it's going to be a pink flower or a red flower or a blue flower like this borage flower? And isn't that a pretty blue? Have you learned a little bit about the relationship between the leaf and the root and the sprout and the bud to the plant? Have you learned a little bit about plants with me? I hope so. And paint is such a wonderful material to investigate nature, to study nature, because it's so alive and moving, and our hand is moving with it. I like these lines that come down from the top of the stalk to the point of the bud. And they're like little pages that are going to open. And there we are, our very delicate little bud. And you have a good day. And before we go, let's remember to clean our brushes well. Wipe off the paint on our brush. And if you're painting with acrylic paint, always leave your brush in water until you fully clean it, or the acrylic polymers will dry on your brush. And thank you, and have a good day.